I got a few accessories here, and I'm going to hope to show them to you on this video, just so you can get a little look at of what came with the Game Boys and some other third-party things that maybe you should know about before you go out and purchase your Game Boy. Or if you're wanting to buy these things, you can get a little look at about how they work. Okay, the first thing is I'm going to talk a little bit more about Game Boy cartridges, because I haven't really brought up too many details about them. I'll ramble on about Game Boy cartridges for a little bit. Here is a Game Boy cartridge. For example, Dr. Mario. This is an official case. Yes, Nintendo made these cases for the Game Boy and Game Boy Color games to go. Well, it wasn't meant for the Game Boy Color games, but they do fit in there. So yeah, that's a cool little case that you got with, I believe, all of your Nintendo games back then. But good luck finding too many of them now. They're not rare, but a lot of people just don't have the case with them. So there's Dr. Mario. Okay, so here I have four cartridges. Game Boy Original, Game Boy Color, Game Boy Color, and Game Boy Advance. This is a Game Boy Original cartridge, worked in every Game Boy except for the Micro. And these games were in black and white, but if you put them into a Game Boy Color, Game Boy Advance, or Game Boy Advance SP, you can change the color scheme that they appear in. So I believe it gives you a few color, well, it does give you a few color choices for you to actually play the game in, and if you don't pick one of the color choices, it will come up with one for you. Most games, the colors were green and blue automatically, but some of them that came out from Nintendo did have their own color schemes programmed for them. So that's Game Boy Original. These are the Game Boy Color games that a lot of people recognize. These are see-through. They work on Game Boy Color, Game Boy Advance, and Game Boy Advance SP. Yeah, they're see-through. They are definitely programmed in color. So they will not work on the older Game Boys. This one here is also a Game Boy Color cartridge, but it will work on older Game Boys. This is a simplified color cartridge, which means it's not as advanced as the clear ones, but it will have a lot of colors to it if you put it into a Game Boy Color. But if you put it into a black and white Game Boy, such as a Pocket or Light or something, or the original, it will appear in black and white. And they are the same as the gray ones, except for they're black. The little one here is a Game Boy Advance game. It worked in the Game Boy Advance, Game Boy Advance SP, and the Game Boy Micro. This thing is half the size of the older ones. Runs in 32-bit, whereas the older ones only ran in 8-bit. These will not run in any Game Boy before the Game Boy Color. Or the Game Boy Color itself. This will not run in those. So there is your Game Boy cartridges explained. Here's another special cartridge for the Game Boy Advance, the Game Boy Advance Video. Yes, there were Game Boy Advance Video cartridges that were made specifically to play on the Game Boy Advance or SP or Micro. And yes, they actually do have videos. This one is the Fairly Odd Parents as an example. There were full-length movie ones like Shrek. They also had SpongeBob ones. But the picture, of course, was nowhere near as good as an iPod would give you or a computer or anything. Because you're playing it on a Game Boy Advance, it's very, very compressed, and it doesn't look good at all. But it is a Game Boy Color video, a Game Boy Advance video cartridge, and it's kind of cool how they came out. It's the same size as a regular one, except it's just very light gray. If you were to buy your Game Boy Advance game or Game Boy Color game new, I don't have a box for an original game, but here's an example of a Game Boy Color cartridge box. This is Tetris DX, and what it would look like if you opened it up brand new, of course it would be shrink-wrapped, but your game is right on top, Tetris DX, and your manuals are in the back there. And Game Boy Advance, such as Mario & Luigi Superstar Saga, same kind of thing, your Game Boy Advance game would go there and your manuals are in the back. So the Game Boy boxes didn't really change all that much. They are square. They're thick. But those are the boxes that you got them in. Well, now I'll quickly show you some link cables here. This one is for the original Game Boy. This is the original Game Boy link cable. I don't think this has ever been unwrapped. I can see that it's been opened, but never unwrapped, because it's almost wrapped perfectly. Got it for a dollar. But yes, that's the end of it. And it would go, the other end would go into another Game Boy. And you could play two players or trade Pokemon or whatever your game allows you to do. So here's the Game Boy. It went right in there. Now, I do not have the cover for this link cable slot. There, if you were to buy it new, there would be a cover on there. And when you're to prevent dust, when you're done with the link cable, you would put it back on. Here's another link cable. This one is a non-official one, not made by Nintendo. It doesn't really have a brand name on it anywhere. But, yes, this is a special edition one where it would work with a Game Boy. And if you didn't have another Game Boy, say if you had a Game Boy Pocket Light or Color, that's the end that would go into the Pocket Light or Color. So, you can play across two different kinds of Game Boys, or you can play with two original, or you can play with two Game Boy Color Pocket Lights. So, non-official link cable, but it is pretty cool what it allows you to do. Now, the Game Boy, this is the Game Boy Pocket, the Game Boy Light and the Game Boy Color have the same link cable port. The Game Boy Original does not have the same one, so this allows you to play between the two. This is the Game Boy Advance link cable. It plugged into the Game Boy Advance. The other one plugged into your other Game Boy Advance. Now, this would work with the Game Boy Advance and the Game Boy Advance SP. That's it. And in here, if you were to do three or four players or more, you would plug the purple end into that and the gray end into your other Game Boy. So you can play a lot of Game Boys with just a few link cables instead of buying adapters for four players and all that junk. But yes, this is official. This is official Nintendo. I'm not going to bother to unwrap it because there's all the things are visible right here. But that's how that one worked. This one goes from the Game Boy Advance or Game Boy Advance SP to the GameCube. There were specially designed games for the GameCube and the Game Boy Advance that allow them to connect to each other, such as Wind Waker. Yes, this is very big. It went across the entire top of the Game Boy, and this went into a controller slot on your GameCube. And I will review the GameCube later. But this is a very cool thing. I actually got it brand new. One super cool thing, believe it or not, a record breaker. In 1999, this was the world record of the world's smallest functional digital camera. The Game Boy camera. I have the red one. It is in very nice condition. But yes, you can plug this into your Game Boy, and maybe I'll review this sometime. But you plug it in your Game Boy just like a regular cartridge, and it worked with every Game Boy except the SP and Micro. Because in the SP it would work, but the camera is upside down. And in the Micro it doesn't work at all. But yeah, you plug this right into the cartridge slot, and it had the ability to take 30 pictures for you in grainy black and white. But it was really cool. And there's also games on it and stuff. Yeah, I'll probably show you this later. Here's a thing that paired very nicely with the Game Boy camera. The Game Boy printer. I can't demo this because it prints way too light, but it is in very nice condition. Took 6 AA batteries. There's your link cable slot. And this would plug into the Game Boy and attach with your Game Boy game. And some Game Boy games had features where you could actually use them to print out things on the paper. And this is adhesive paper. Yeah, I'll review this separately. If you were to buy new Game Boy printer paper, this is what it would look like in a Game Boy printer paper box. There were 3 rolls, one of each of yellow, red, and blue. There's the back of it. You can take a look at it there if you want. This is another non-official Nintendo product, but if you didn't like your boring D-pad on your Game Boy Advance SP, here's this. You could slip it right onto your Game Boy Advance SP, it goes right through the hole. There's a little slot to turn on your power, and yes, you have gigantic A and B buttons, and a big D-pad, just like in an arcade. Here's something, another non-official Nintendo thing, called the Brite Beam. And this thing clipped right onto your Nintendo Game Boy, original, only worked with the original, and it magnified the screen. So it seems like an arcade, looks like an arcade, and you can see the screen a lot better. It's really cool, but unfortunately, unless you're under the sun, you can't really see it, because what's supposed to happen, if I were to take the back handle off, when you insert two AAA or AA batteries, I forget which it is, I think it's AA, there's supposed to be a light that comes on, but for some reason there's absolutely no light in this thing whatsoever. So I thought, as a future project one day, I probably will install a switch and a light to work with both AA batteries, and we'll see how that goes. But for now, it's unusable to me, but it's still a fun thing to look at. And finally, I'll show you these, but I don't know anything about them. These are two gigantic Game Boy cartridges that also accept other Game Boy cartridges. This would plug into your Game Boy, this would attach to another game. I have no idea what either of these two things do. I got them free, and they didn't come with a manual or anything. This one's called the GameShark Pro, for use with Game Boy Color and Game Boy Pocket. I imagine these things probably have something to do with Pokemon, considering how popular they were. It has two buttons on top, a switch and a button. And this one's just a plain old box with one button on the back. This one's called the Brain Boy. If anyone knows what these things do, please tell me in a comment or message or email or something. GoombasAreEvil@iCloud.com. But I have no idea what these do, so if anyone can tell me, I would greatly appreciate it. But that's all the Game Boy accessories that I have to show for right now. Stay tuned for the next video. See you later!